Good morning, students. In the last class, we have discussed about all of the organelles of the eukaryotic cell. Now, let us discuss the significance of the organization of the cell. The organization of the cell refers to the arrangement of biological membranes and organelles in a specific way in the cell. This organization of the cell, it makes the cell to acquire its specific structure and to acquire the ability to perform its specific function. So, how the different biological membranes and organelles are arranged in the cell makes the cell to acquire its specific structure. And because of its specific structure, it will get the ability to perform its specific function. So, the organization of the cell makes the cell to acquire its specific structure and to acquire the ability to perform its specific function. Okay. As Virchow has told, all cells arise from the pre-existing cells. So, there is a special process by which new cells are made. There is a special process by which new cells are made. That process is called cell division. What is cell division? The process by which new cells are made from the previous existing cells. The process by which the new cells are made from the previous existing cells is called cell division. Why the new cells are formed? Why the new cells have to be formed in a complex multicellular organism or in any cellular organism? The cell division is taking place, or the new cells are formed for the growth to take place, for the repair to occur, and in some special instances, for the gametes to be formed. So, in order to grow, to replace or repair the dead cells or injured cells, to replace the old or dead cells, or to repair the damaged or injured cells, and to form the gametes. Gametes are the special cells which are also called germ cells that are used in sexual reproduction process. So, for all these three processes, cell division takes place. There are two types of cell division: mitosis and meiosis. Mitosis is called equational division and meiosis is called reductional division. As we already have discussed, to grow, to replace old or dead or damaged cells, the mitosis takes place. And for the gametes to be formed, meiosis takes place in specialized cells of the reproductive organs of complex multicellular organisms. Okay. So, mitosis is also called equational division. Why mitosis is called equational division? Because by mitosis, two daughter cells are formed, and each daughter cell will have equal or same number of chromosomes to that of the mother cell. Because the number of chromosomes in the daughter cells are same. The number of chromosomes in the daughter cells is same to that of the mother cell in mitosis. So, mitosis is also called equational division. Equal. Chromosome numbers are equal in daughter cells to that of mother cell. So, this cell division is called equational division. By mitosis, two daughter cells only are formed. If any cell is undergoing mitosis, it is going to form how many daughter cells? Only two daughter cells. And each daughter cell will have equal number of chromosomes in all normal conditions. Each daughter cell will have equal number of chromosomes in all normal conditions. In some different or special conditions, the chromosome numbers may be varying, but those conditions are very, very rare. So, the daughter cells will have equal number of chromosomes with what? With their mother cell. With their mother cell. So, it is called equational division. Okay. And mitosis is the mostly occurring cell division in most of the organisms. Because reproduction, it does not take place continuously. Okay. Or frequent times in any complex multicellular organisms. Whereas in unicellular organelles, reproduction may be taking place continuously. So in those unicellular organelles, for reproduction itself, mitosis is required. Because in unicellular organelles, reproduction is generally carried out by fission or by normal mitosis. Okay. So mitosis is the mostly occurring cell division. As we already have discussed, the function of mitosis is growth and repair. Okay. If you look at this cell that is undergoing mitosis, there are four chromosomes in it. Before undergoing mitosis, in the chromosomes, the DNA content will get doubled. Means the chromosome will be getting doubled. Then these chromosomes will be divided equally into two daughter cells. So that finally, whatever the number of chromosomes, whatever the genetic content is there in the mother cell, same number of chromosomes and same genetic content is going to come in the daughter cells. Okay, this is how the equational division of mitosis is carried out. And this particular phase is called synthetic phase during mitosis, during which the DNA content of the cell or the chromosome content will get doubled. Number will not get doubled, only content gets doubled during synthesis phase. Okay. Next, coming to meiosis. Meiosis is also called reductional division. Why is it called reductional division? We will discuss afterwards. Meiosis occurs in specific cells of reproductive organs in all sexually reproducing organisms. Say, whether they are plants or animals, if they are carrying out sexual reproduction in them, there are some specific organs or tissues in them in which the special cells are going to carry out this meiosis. Okay. So by meiosis, the gametes are formed. These gametes are going to combine with each other. Male and female gametes that are formed from male and female reproductive organs get combined with each other, which is also called fertilization, and form a combined cell called zygote. This zygote will undergo several mitotic divisions and offspring or the new organism is produced. Meiosis involves two divisions. In mitosis only one division is there, whereas in meiosis two divisions are there. Okay. After these two divisions from one mother cell, four daughter cells are formed by meiosis. After these two divisions from one mother cell, four daughter cells are formed in meiosis. And each daughter cell will get only half the number of chromosomes and half the genetic content to that of their mother cell. And each daughter cell will get only half the number of chromosomes and half the genetic content to that of their mother cell. How the meiosis is carried out, let us look at it. Here, in this cell, four chromosomes are there. Like in mitosis, here in meiosis also, the synthetic phase or S phase is carried out by which the chromosome content, DNA content gets doubled. And these chromosomes, now they get separated. Now they get separated half the number. But the genetic content in each chromosome is still in double in quantity. Now, each of these cell will undergo second meiotic division and it will divide into half the genetic content having chromosomes. So finally, we are getting four daughter cells from one mother cell. And here in mother cell, four chromosomes are there, whereas in daughter cell, only two chromosomes are there. Thus, chromosome number is reduced by half. As chromosome number is reduced by half in daughter cells by meiosis, meiosis is also called reductional division. This is how mitosis and meiosis are taking place and which will help for the effective survival of the living organisms, both for the maintenance of the structure as well as for their reproduction. So this is the fundamental unit of life chapter is completed. Thank you.